Those who are happy, let them raise their hands.
Oh,
thank you, Jesus. Let us give a big hands of praise to our Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise to Jesus.
Amen.
So, we are going to the Word of God. But today I'm not going to preach. I'm going to sit down and enjoy the Word of God. Because among us, we have got Pastor Michael. All the way from Sweden. He is my friend. So he's going to preach the word today.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sabunane kalebelika Jesu. Injani. Niyabonga kakhulu. Ngulungulani busise.
Amen.
Amen. Yesterday I was preparing this sermon. And suddenly there were some words that popped up in my mind. Well done, my faithful servant. Your reward will be great. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I believe this is the word of the Lord to this church. You see, we are all called to serve the Lord. Whether we are young or old, whether we are men or women, we are all called to serve the Lord and each other. And the Lord has given us gifts to serve with. So no matter how much resources you have, you have received gifts from the Holy Spirit to serve others. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us turn to the first letter of Peter, chapter 4.
First
Peter 4, verse 8 to 10. Above all, love each other deeply, because love covers over a multitude of sins. Offer hospitality to one another without grumbling, and each one should use whatever gift he has received to serve others, faithfully administering God's grace in his various forms. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God has given us gifts to serve others. The purpose of the gifts of the Holy Spirit is to serve. And that is why it is so important that we love each other. And the Word of God says that we should offer hospitality. To be sharing with what we have. And above all, use the gifts of the Holy Spirit to serve. And I have some very good news for you. I believe that the Holy Spirit will equip this church to see miracles and healings and prophecies. And be able to serve other people that way. You see, in Acts chapter 3, there is a story of Peter and John. In this chapter, it says that Peter and John, they passed by a lame man. And this man was begging because he couldn't get a job. If you were crippled in the time of the Bible, you could not get a job. So this man asked Peter and John for some money. But then in verse 6, Peter is replying, silver or gold I do not have, what I have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk. And Peter took the hand of the lame man and he walked.
And then Peter and
the man was filled with joy. He was so happy. So not only did he walk, but he started to jump like this. Hallelujah. God did a miracle. And in this miracle, he did not only deliver the man from being crippled, but also from living in poverty. Because now he was able to work. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you see, it's really funny that Peter says, I don't have silver or gold. Peter was the leader of the church. And yet he didn't have any money. But he had something better. He had the Holy Spirit. He had the gift of healing. And no matter how much money you have, God wants to use you and to serve others. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have a friend back home in Sweden. His name is Elijah. And originally he comes from the Middle East, but he was a refugee, so he came to Sweden. And it's very hard to be an immigrant in Sweden. So he was very poor, he didn't have much money. But when he was in Sweden, Jesus showed himself to him. So before he was a Muslim, but now he became a Christian. And God gave him an amazing gift of prophecy. So he started to hear the voice of the Lord. And he started to have dreams and visions when Jesus appeared to him. And then he could serve others through that gift. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So one night, Jesus showed himself to Elijah in a dream. And Jesus said, remember when you were studying Swedish and there was a man cleaning the classroom? I want you to lead him to faith in me. And Elijah said, I would love to do that, but he lives in another city and I don't have money for the taxi. And then Jesus said, 8 o'clock in the morning, go to your mailbox. Because there will be money there. And then the dream ended and Elijah woke up. And he couldn't sleep. He was very excited. So he called a friend and told him about this. And the friend said, I have to see this. So the friend came to Elijah's house with his car. So his friend, he wanted to make sure that Elijah wasn't tricking him. So he went and looked into the mailbox and it was empty. And then they sat in the car and they was just looking at the mailbox. And they were sitting there for hours. And they were so excited because they wondered what will happen 8 o'clock. Will an angel come and put money in the mailbox? Or will the money come down from heaven? They were so excited. And then the time were 8 o'clock. And nothing happened. And they were very disappointed. But Elijah said, let us look in the mailbox. So they went to the box and opened it. And inside was a letter. And Elijah's name was written in gold letters. And inside was some money that he could use for the bus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when Elijah's friend saw this, he was filled with fear of the Lord. He realized that this is a supernatural miracle. So he went down on his knees and he said, oh God, I'm a sinner, forgive my sins. Because he realized that this was impossible. God had put the money in that mailbox. So Elijah was very happy. And he took the bus to the other city. And he went to the home of this cleaning man. And he discovered that this man was living a very sinful life. So he was actually having a drug party where they were taking drugs with some of his friends. And when Elijah knocked the door, he opened and said, who are you? What do you want? And Elijah said, I want to tell you that Jesus loves you. Go away! Out of here! If you come back, I will kill you. And the man closed the door.
And then in the
and Elijah was very disappointed.
Elijah
he realized that there was no idea in trying to knock again. So he had no alternative but to leave. And he was so sad and he was crying. And he asked the Lord, this wasn't supposed to happen. You have provided for me supernaturally to lead this man to you. But then Elijah heard some footsteps behind him. So there was this man running towards him. And he grabbed him and said, I want to be saved. Okay. So the man explained that when he had closed the door, he felt like electricity was going through his body. And all his life was visible in front of him. And he could see that he has been living a very sinful life. That he was in need of a savior. So today, this man is a Christian. He is a missionary. Going around the world preaching the gospel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now when I've been here in South Africa, I have met another friend. He is called Surprise Sithole.
Surprise Sithole.
He is the founder of the Bible College where Sibusiso is working.
He found that Bible College lapho umfundisi asebenza khona.
And he is a true man of God.
God
has given him so many gifts.
And
all his life he has been using these gifts to serve other people.
And
to serve the kingdom of God.
So
when he was 15 years old, he started preaching. He went around to different villages to preach the gospel. At first in Mozambique and then later in Malawi. But when he came to Malawi, there was a problem. He came to a village where he didn't know the language. And the people there, they didn't know his language. But anyway, he gathered them for a prayer meeting. So all the people were at a prayer meeting and they were singing their songs in their language.
And
then Surprise started to preach.
And they
didn't understand a word.
They were
sitting like this. What is that boy saying? And there was a big problem. Surprise really wanted these people to hear the gospel. So he just continued to preach. And after a while, God did a miracle. So suddenly he was preaching their language.
He was
preaching in Chichewa.
And he
knew that language supernaturally. So the people were convicted that God is really working through this boy. He didn't know our language, but now he does.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So there was a church planted in that village.
And
even the first Bible that Surprise had was in
Chichewa.
A language he has never learned in school.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So God can give us this gift to serve other people.
And
God wants to give these gifts to everyone.
And when
we have the power of the Holy Spirit, there are no limitations to what we can do.
With
the power of the Holy Spirit, we can be a blessing to thousands of people. No matter how young or old we
are.
No matter if we are men or women. We can all be used by the Holy Spirit to serve others.
We
can all be used by the Holy Spirit to spread His love. We can all be used by the Holy Spirit to spread His gospel. Hallelujah.
Amen.